Welcome to this quick look at careers in the Natural Resources Conservation Service. The NRCS, as we're known, is an agency of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. Our agency is responsible for helping private landowners and managers manage the resources on America's private lands. Our basic mission is to help people help the land. Our conservation programs are voluntary, so the people that we serve want us to help them develop the necessary steps to conserve soil, protect wildlife, restore water quality, keep air clean, and conserve energy and promote good land use, all for the benefit of future generations. The people of NRCS are recognized for their talent, dedication, their passion, and professionalism they bring to protecting and improving working landscapes. Healthy landscapes support strong rural economies and lifestyles. We ensure the health of our private land natural resource treasures. I'd like you to meet some of the special NRCS employees working with me here in the state of Utah. The careers that they will introduce you to are available in every state and territory in the United States. We have more than 12,000 employees nationwide.
As a wildlife biologist, I believe I have the best job in the NRCS. Essentially, I help people build and protect habitat for fish and wildlife. This entails working with private landowners and many other partner organizations, such as the state wildlife agencies, to assess habitat conditions, like I'm doing today, and implement on-the-ground projects to benefit a whole variety of species. NRCS is the only federal agency charged primarily with helping private landowners conserve natural resources. And since roughly 70% of the country is privately owned, most wildlife species depend upon private lands during at least some portion of their life cycle. Also, some of the most productive and important lands are often located on private land, such as riparian areas, wetlands, and streams. In my career with NRCS so far, I've helped restore and protect wetlands in a rapidly developing area for a declining species called the Columbia spotted frog. I've also worked with livestock ranchers to improve habitat for species such as sage grouse, antelope, and other wildlife. To become a biologist for the NRCS, you'll have to earn a bachelor's degree in one of the biological sciences. This entails taking several courses in biology, math, chemistry, and other natural resource related disciplines.
I'm a soil conservationist in the Price Field Office. I assist farmers, ranchers, and other interested groups in planning a resource management system conservation plan. After finding out the farmer's resource concerns, we'll go out into the field and observe his soils and his water conditions, his crop production, his animals, and then we'll go back into the office, create a conservation plan on the computer. After the plan has been created, we'll take it back out to the farmer and he'll look over the plan. If he's satisfied with what we have planned, he will sign the contract and then we will proceed in implementing his plan. I enjoy working for this agency because I have the opportunity to help people help the land. To become a soil conservationist, you must have a bachelor's degree in the field of natural resources or agricultural field and take at least 12 hours in crop and soils or plant sciences. I obtained my degree from Langston University in Oklahoma with a degree in natural resource management agricultural.
I'm a geographic information specialist with the state. One of the things that attracted me to this position is the use of technology to support the field offices. Geographic information systems are a collection of computer software, hardware, and geographic information. This allows users to see trends, patterns, and relationships that are not noticeable with traditional maps. GIS allows the planner to easily see where conservation practices need to be applied to the land. The tablet is a mobile device that allows me to work outside with the landowner. This allows for instant viewing and editing of the data. Global positioning systems use satellite technology, which allows me to pinpoint my exact location. With this data, we can use the plotter to print maps, which shows great detail on conservation plans. to qualify for this job, I had a degree in geography. And if you wanted to qualify for this job, you would want to be interested in geography, geology, and statistics.
My name's Randy Julander. I'm the data collection officer. Basically, we measure snow. We measure precipitation, we measure temperature, we measure soil moisture and all these parameters. We take the data that we collect and turn that into water supply forecasts for agriculture, for municipalities, for dam operations, for floods, for droughts, for hydroelectric generation, all kinds of purposes. Recreation is a side benefit from having this kind of information. People want to know how deep the snow is, how much snow fell in the last 24 hours, how much snow fell in the last 7 days. They want to go where it's steep and where it's deep. And we provide data to the Avalanche Forecast Center for making avalanche forecasts. We provide data to all kinds of recreational clubs that use it to determine where they want to go play. A career like this one typically requires huge amounts of math and science. I have a bachelor's and a master's degree in hydrology, and most of the people that work for me, they all have bachelor's in hydrology, and most of them have master's degrees.
I'm a rangeland management specialist, and I get to work to try and protect our natural rangelands, because rangelands contribute a lot to our economy through livestock, wildlife, recreation opportunities, and watershed function. I get to work in a variety of landscapes, from shrublands to grasslands to streams and wet meadows. My work is never boring. I get to evaluate grasses, look at plant diversity and plant production, and I get to talk with land managers and operators to discuss management opportunities for them. I'm part of a planning team, and we work together to identify problems, complete inventories, and develop alternative solutions. A favorite part of my job is being able to pass on knowledge to land managers and land operators to help facilitate positive change for conservation. What I do can be compared to the medical profession. I treat the health of the rangeland by diagnosing problems and symptoms and implementing solutions. To become a rangeland management specialist, you need a background in biology or a related agricultural field. Range ecology and wildlife biology are particularly important. I graduated with a wildlife biology degree and a minor in range ecology.
I'm an agronomist working for the Natural Resource Conservation Service here in the northern part of Utah. My job's kind of twofold as an area agronomist. I help teach the field staff and also work with landowners. Basically, I teach agronomic principles such as crop science and pest management. Working with farmers, teaching them about pest management involves the integrated pest management approach. One of those approaches is to make sure that that producer sweeps his fields, which is scouting for these insects before they make a pesticide or herbicide application. Nutrient management involves taking soil samples and comparing the nutrients in the soil with crop uptake. We're trying to do this to help the farmer to avoid over-application or under-application of both his manure and commercial fertilizer. Improving irrigation efficiency teaches the proper amount and timing of irrigations. As an agronomist, you're required to have a bachelor's degree in an agronomic field. You know, the whole key to this job is that you're teaching farmers to conserve their natural resources, which are plant, soils, animals, water, and air.
Contrary to popular opinion, soil is not dirt. It is the dynamic natural body of mineral, organic, and living matter that covers the whole earth. Soil and soil conservation has been central to this agency's mission since its inception. In fact, NRCS started as the Soil Erosion Service in 1933. As an NRCS soil scientist, you'll be part of a team charged with classifying and mapping the nation's soil resources. Soil mapping requires you to integrate knowledge of soil science, geology, hydrology, biology, and ecology. You'll use new high-tech tools like GPS and geographic information systems, as well as old tried and true tools like backhoes and shovels, to make maps of soil types used in making important land management decisions. What I like best about the job is the great balance between field work and office work. Soil scientists with NRCS work with a wide variety of customers. You get to work with soil data in a variety of formats, from older paper maps to new digital maps on the internet. To prepare for a career as an NRCS soil scientist, you need to have a degree in soil science or a closely related discipline, with at least 30 semester hours in the biological, chemical, or geological sciences, and at least 15 hours of direct soils courses.
I'm the district conservationist in Garfield and King counties. I manage the Pengridge Field Office. I manage all the Farm Bill programs here. I oversee the conservation planning, and I manage 3 employees. This job entails some computer work, but the part that I like the best is the field work. We work with private landowners putting conservation on the ground. Some of the work that we do in this area with the landowners, we help them a lot with their irrigation systems. We have a lot of hay land and pasture land here, and a lot of it is historically flood irrigated, and we've moved into the big sprinkler systems. Another thing that we do a lot of is range work, controlling invasive species like sagebrush and rabbit brush, and planting some plants that cows would rather eat. I work a lot with their community organizations. I work with 3 soil conservation districts. I also work with county governments. We have weed boards, 2 weed boards that I work with, helping them locate places where there are noxious weeds that need to be controlled. To prepare me for this job, I went to college. I got a degree in agriculture sciences with an emphasis on plant sciences. This is a good job if you like working with people and you like working with natural resources.
I'm a civil engineer on the state conservationist engineering staff. The engineering staff consists of an irrigation engineer, a design engineer, and an environmental engineer. As an engineer, I primarily consist of doing a lot of project planning, where we actually go out and collect data. And collecting data might be in the office where we download GIS data, might go out to the field to inventory and collect data, come back in the office and we develop models to analyze the data, and then we propose and look at designs for those projects. Some of the projects I work on are watershed rehabilitation. We look at the actual dam that's been designed, and part of this is to look at the watershed and determine how much flow is coming off that watershed and determine if the dam meets current criteria. We also have EWP, Emergency Watershed Protection Program, where we help communities after natural disasters occur to help stabilize either the streams or some type of event that devastated the community. What I enjoy about this career is that I'm able to start a project, study the project, and finalize a project. I appreciate being involved in every single step and contributing to the team as far as working with biologists, agronomists, soil scientists, geologists, and other planners. To have a career in civil engineering, you must have a bachelor's degree in science and civil engineering or other related fields.
I'm an administrative assistant in the USDA Career Intern Program. Here in the state office, this position affords me the opportunity to work with employees, our partners, and the public in efforts that further our Natural Resources Conservation Service vision, productive lands, and a healthy environment. NRCS offers great opportunities in administrative careers, and there are employment programs specifically designed for students. In my position, I will be learning how the human resources staff assists employees in every stage of their careers. I'll help build partnerships through the federal contracting and procurement processes, and I'll also gain firsthand experience learning to manage a federal budget. Education requirements for administrative jobs vary. For some positions, no degree is necessary, and for others, you need a 4-year degree. If you are looking for a stable employer, good benefits, and a secure retirement, and you want to play an active role in securing our natural resources for future generations, then this agency is right for you. It was certainly a good fit for me. For more information about vacancies with the Natural Resources Conservation Service, please log on to the USA Jobs website.